Good morning, everyone. We welcome all parishioners and visitors as we prepare to celebrate the 21st Sunday of Ordinary Time. Our next senior social will take place next Wednesday, August 28th, at the Grand Oak Culinary Market in Vineland. Please RSVP the office by this Monday if you would like to join us. Carpooling will be arranged. Our celebrant today is Father Rico. Please stand and join in our processional hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather at this Mass in praise and worship of our God, we pray in a special way for the repose of the souls of Stephen and Agnes Bach, and for the special intention for the Digba family. I invite all the special friends of Jesus to come forward for our children's liturgy. Come on down, friends. Friends, the scriptures this weekend, Jesus talks to us about making good choices. And when we do what Jesus would always do, it's always the right choice. Let's ask Jesus to help us to make holy choices this week. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. She's going to be our leader. Follow the leader, friends.
Children go to hear God's word. Children go to hear good news. Children go with joy to hear God's word. Children go to hear good news.
For the times we fail to make holy choices, choosing sin over God's love, we bow our heads and ask for his mercy. For God is slow to anger and abounding in steadfast mercy and love. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those who are in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Joshua. Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and summoned the elders, the heads, the judges, and the officers of Israel, and they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, "If you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, who did those great signs in our sight. He protected us along all the way that we went and among all the peoples through whom we passed. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God." The word of the Lord.
Goodness.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another as God in Christ has forgiven you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, be subject to your husbands as you are to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, the body of which he is the Savior. Just as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives ought to be in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, in order to make her holy by cleansing her with the washing of water by the word, so as to present the church to himself in splendor, without a spot or wrinkle or anything of the kind. Yes, so that she may be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as they do their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hates his own body, but he nourishes and tenderly cares for it, just as Christ does for the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I am applying it to the church, to Christ and the church. The word of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the people, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you." When many of his disciples heard this, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you there are some who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe, and who was the one that would betray him. He said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted them by my Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Life is all about making choices, and the choices we make in this life have a direct impact on how we will be spending eternity. Jesus wants us to always be making holy choices, choices that are rooted in gospel values, choices that follow what Jesus would do in a particular situation. It is so important that we are making choices not based on our own feelings, our own emotions, and our own best interests, but that we are making choices that would be pleasing to Almighty God. Joshua, in the first reading, calls out the people and says, you can't sit on the fence by the way how you're living your life. You're either going to serve God or you're not. And the same goes for us. Friends, focus on Father Rico. Don't focus on the altar servers. Focus on Father Rico. This is important. This is about God's word. Joshua says to the people, are you focusing and you're going to follow Almighty God, the same God that was faithful to your ancestors, or not? Make the choice. You can't sit on the fence. You're either going to follow him or you're not. And Joshua says boldly, for me and my household, I will follow the Lord. And while we might at first glance say to ourselves, oh yeah, that's true for me too, we have to ask ourselves, are our choices in accordance with what God asks? Are our choices in accordance with what God asks? Every moment of every day could be filled with a choice to make. Sometimes our choices are little ones. What am I going to wear today? What am I going to eat today? How am I going to spend my 24 hours today? These can be daily mundane choices that we don't necessarily have to flood heaven to determine what we should be doing. But those bigger choices, how we speak to one another, how I react in a particular situation, this is so important. There's a very popular phrase, WWJD, what would Jesus do? And it's not something for children, it's something for all of us to pick up on. Because if I'm making choices like Jesus would choose to do, then I'm always making the right choice. It's not something I'm going to regret. It's not something when I make the choice, I'm going to think to myself, I've been duped. Why did I do that? Because when we make choices that are God-centered, when I look at others through the lens of Jesus and say, what would Jesus do here? He'd probably bite his tongue. So should I. Because it's not about having the final word. It's not about being right. It's about doing what's right. And if we are constantly making choices that are God-centered choices, that are rooted in love, then we have nothing to worry about. Because when I'm making holy choices, then I'm pleasing God. Now, making the holy and the right choice is not always the easiest choice. In fact, many times it's the opposite. And yet we can still live knowing, as St. Paul says in the second reading, that if we put our needs second to God and other, then our lives will be filled with joy. And so this isn't about who's in charge in the marriage, because sadly the second reading gets misinterpreted. What it's saying is that husbands and wives should be placing themselves second to the other. Because that's what love is. Love is rooted in sacrifice. Love is not rooted in what's in it for me, what's in my best interest. When I think like that, I become a statistic, because this isn't going to work. But when I think about making holy choices and say, I'm willing, as St. Paul says, to lay down my life like Christ did for his church, we're saying that I'm going to put my needs second. So maybe the right response is, yes, dear. As opposed to battling and battling and battling, right? Because I got to be right. I have to make the decision. I'm in charge. We can become very frustrated if we live lives focused on that. Not just those of you who are married. Myself as a priest. It's inconvenient to get the hospital call in the middle of the night. I have to choose to not only answer the phone and get out of bed, because I can say, oh yeah, Jesus, I love you. I love you. I'm your priest. But am I living the priesthood? Because it's not just about going to the hospital. You know, it's 3 a.m. You could have called. How long have you been here? 3 weeks, Father. And you called me at 3 a.m. That's not still making the right choice because I went. But what's my attitude like? I'm just barking at the people. That's not making the holy choice. So just showing up isn't good enough either. Just showing up for Mass today isn't enough. If our heart and soul are not rooted in God, Jesus says, the greatest commandment is to love your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your strength. We need to make choices that show God, God, you are my number one. And even when you're asking me to make the tough choice, I'm committed to doing it because you're asking me to do it, and it's the right decision. But our consciences need to be shaped in Jesus because, as he said to the apostles, he says to us, right? How many people live in Grimsby? We're the only Catholic church in Grimsby. This church should be jammed. But many people have walked away. Jesus isn't number one, or they say he's number one, but they're not living it. Jesus says, honor the Lord's day. Every Sunday is Mass, most important thing. That's the only choice. We want to go to heaven, we must feast on his flesh and blood. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. So he asks, are you also going to go with them? Family members and friends in your own families have gone away. You're going to follow them? You're going to follow Jesus. Because he's showing us the path. It may not always be the popular path, but it's the only path. But the choice is ours. Adam and Eve made their choice. They chose to listen to the serpent, the father of lies. And many times, we might be duped to do the same thing. But Jesus wants us to really focus, to be more like Joshua, to be reminded of how great our God is, as the psalm tells us. Taste and see the goodness of God. God who laid down his life for me. No one else has laid down their life for me. Nobody else cares enough about me that they would leave the paradise of heaven to come down to earth to make sure that I'm paying attention, that I make the right choices, so I can spend eternity with him. Only Jesus would do such things. And so there's only one choice. And yet, so many of us are foolish when we make choices that are not holy. I've been a priest 13 years. I've celebrated many funerals. I have yet to go to a funeral where the person said, you know what? I'm glad this person's dead because they loved too much. Thank God they're gone. Too much love. Good riddance, right? Not once. Any of you? Some of you are older than me. Most of you are 21, I know. Anyone have that experience? But the opposite is very true, right? Every single time. Oh, man, I'm going to miss this person. They were so loving. They were so kind. They were so this. In my life, they did this for me or that to me. That's my this, that, right? When you love, that's what the character trait that we revere and we thank God. Lord, thank you for this person who was so loving. When we see people who lay down their life, who put their own needs second to somebody else, that's living like Christ. That's seeing through the lens of the Lord Jesus. That's making holy choices. We celebrate and lift these people up. These people are the canonized saints of our church who continue like St. Louis. Today's feast is St. Louis, who remind us of how to live, to make holy choices because it's always the right thing. And let's face it, when we make good choices, we don't live with regret. Oh, but Father Rico, sometimes I've made the right choice and people have taken advantage of me. Welcome to the club, friends. If they stab Jesus in the back, you think you're more important than him? Of course you're going to get stabbed in the back. He prepares us for that. Father and mother will be against you. Brother and sister will be against you. But if you are persecuted in my name, what does he say about that? What's the end of that sentence? Your reward will be great in heaven. So I need to celebrate it, because when I'm making the right choice, the reward is coming. Sometimes we see the reward now, yes. But actually, we should be more focused on choices that have eternal rewards. Like I said last week, I was shocked by your response when I talked about the elders that told me to invest in my future. Because in the moment when you're 15, it's all about the moment. But then you realize the fruits of it later on. And when we make holy choices, sometimes we may even regret it. Say, Lord, you know, this sucks. I got taken advantage of. But sometimes as time passes, I'm so glad I made that choice, Lord. Even though I may have been taken advantage in the moment. But I put a smile on your face because that's all that matters. Because when the cards are down, it's all about Jesus. When the cards are down, the only person who have our back is he who laid down his life for his friends. The good shepherd who calls us to make holy choices. So in our marriages, it's not about being right. What's best for my spouse? What's best for my family? Go to work and go home and love your family. That's the right choice. Stop going to the bar. Stop working overtime. You don't need the money, and you definitely don't need the other substances. Your family needs you. As we prepare for school, that commitment, that beautiful dedication of putting down our life, making those lunches, making sure homework is done, getting them to school on time, that makes Jesus happy. These are holy choices. The beauty of family life. Those of us who are single, whether religious or choose to be single, right? To lay down one's life for others. Each of us are called to do that. It's not just reserved for married people. St. Paul says, make the right choice. Do what Jesus would do. And the more we do that, the happier our lives become. They're not these mundane exercises. But rather, we're showing God that in the mundaneness of daily life, we experience joy in the love that God has put with people in our midst, whether our families are very small or quite large. Making holy choices. They are rooted in the Eucharist. And the Eucharist, who is Jesus, gives us the strength to go about our lives. So are we going to choose to be like Joshua? Regardless of what our family members, regardless what social trends are, Jesus is asking the same question as he asked his disciples to you and me. Do you also wish to go away? May our response be like Joshua and St. Peter. For me and my household, I will serve the Lord. Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. There is one choice to make. Are we going to be like Joshua or Peter? What is your choice? Confident in a God who calls us to true faith, to make the right choice, we proudly profess our faith in him using the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We make our needs known to God, who calls us to make holy choices, who guides our lives by showing us the one true path, and who cares for us in our anxieties. And so with confidence, we lift these needs to Him.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That the leaders of the church may follow the Lord with all their heart, with all their strength, and with all their might. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who legislate for us, that they may respect and promote the rights of the family, let us pray to the Lord. For separated spouses, that through Jesus they may rediscover forgiveness and reconciliation, let us pray to the Lord. For families, the source of vocations, that they may encourage their children to respond to vocations to the priesthood and religious life. Let us pray to the Lord. For the sick of our community, especially Aidan Keenan, Bonnie Ryan, Dallas Dudick, Larry Clark, Kelly Kovacs, Michael O'Brien, baby Bianca Carboni, that in their suffering they may rely more than ever on Jesus, let us pray to the Lord. For those who died recently, especially James Ricks, Alma Jack, Pauline McManus, Dennis Jones, Mia Hickey, Jen Aruda Aguar, Licolitza Caravalis, that they may have eternal life promised by Christ, let us pray to the Lord. We also pray for Stephen and Agnes Back and the special intentions of the Digba family. Let us pray to the Lord.
For all the intentions we bring to God from the silence of our hearts. Lord our God, help us to make holy choices. In the Eucharist, you strengthen us by your word and example to always do what you would do. May our thoughts, our words, and actions always reflect that truth, to always do the right thing rather than being right. We ask these and all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. God's law is perfect, refreshing the soul, reviving the weary spirit. God's rule can be trusted, wisdom, bringing God's wisdom to birth. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. God's precepts keep us, their purpose is right, they gladden the people. God's command is so clear, it brings us new vision, bringing God's light to our eyes. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. God's truth is holy and sure, God's presence.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mingling of this water and wine, we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine which we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, of my iniquity. Cleanse me of my many sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice of yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Amen. O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, be so graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Send the Holy Spirit for you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so
so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, Lord, we pray, may the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father, most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Gerard, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, the religious, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also Stephen and Agnes, who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with your apostles, with Saint Paul, Saint Louis, whose feast day we celebrate today, Saint Catherine of Alexandria, the prophet Joshua, and all the saints in your kingdom. They are with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death. May we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
give us the
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Turn and offer one another a sign of the Lord's peace. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free us by this your most holy body and blood from all our sins and from all that is evil. Keep us faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. May the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. For those at home receiving Jesus in a spiritual communion, I invite you to pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us turn to our Blessed Mother as we pray. We fly to thy protection, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Good Saint Joseph, ever watchful guardian of the Holy Family, protect the chosen people of Jesus Christ. Keep us free from the blight of error and corruption, and be our ally in the conflict with the powers of darkness. As of old you rescued the child Jesus from the plots of Herod, so now defend the universal church from all harm. Keep us, one and all, under your continual protection, so that by your help and example, we may lead a holy life, die a happy death, and come to possess eternal life in heaven. Amen. This is our last week of the summer before young people return to school and many of you return to your regular work duties. And so let's make the most of this week in thanking God for all that he gives to us in anticipation of a great year ahead, academically and personally. What's more important than both of those is growing spiritually. And so our programs begin very strongly the first week of September. Our grief support group is now full, so those who have registered, our group is complete. So please pray for those who have lost a loved one recently or struggling in grief, who've lost a loved one for a long time. That group begins on September the 5th. For those who are thinking about becoming Catholic, perhaps yourself, your spouse, somebody you bring to church, or someone you know, what a great opportunity to invite them to come to know Jesus more deeply as they learn about the teachings of Christ and his church as the RCIA program begins this September 11th. Lena and myself will be leading two chosen series groups. For those who've been watching the first three seasons, this will begin season four this early September. And for those who have not yet seen any, we'll begin season one with me on September the 23rd. So we look forward to that. So Monday to Thursday, along with my God Talk Bible study, as we are finishing up 1 Corinthians currently. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, there's a group for you. Don't be in 17 groups, but choose one. Choose that one way in which you're going to grow spiritually and allow God to nourish your souls. Finally, of course, we have some exciting activities coming up. Our Knights of Columbus trivia night. We have our parish purse bingo. Tickets are now on sale. I received the tickets yesterday, so we're ready to go. And we look forward to an awesome night on October the 18th. So lots for you to get involved in. Continue to seek ways in which God can help you to grow spiritually so that we make holy choices that are always pleasing to him. Our NFL pool is also a great way of having fun through the NFL season. I've already chirped Father Ronald because his Patriots are going to be terrible, which is so fantastic because they got more Stanley Cup, listen to me, Stanley Cup, Super Bowl rings. I want a Stanley Cup too for my Leafs, but the reality, it's a great way to chirp each other in our parish as we go through the NFL season, knowing there's only going to be one winner in New Orleans this year, and it better be the Bills Mafia, but with injuries piling up, I'm already worried. It's already going to be tough for us. So we'll see what happens through the NFL season. If you have yet to sign up, please do so as we look forward to our survivor pool. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Mass has ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
When I am surrounded.
for the support.
Well done, Jessica.
Jessica, hey.